once upon a future time in a place called Stardust Bay. Counting down to adventure now. Rockets on a mission, we're on our way. Space racers, surfing the solar winds. Space racers, together the fun begins. Way out where the planets move and stars all shimmer, shine. Having a great time exploring space racers.
Hey, wait for me!
My towel.
Eagle, do you have my headphones?
What?
Ugh, those are my headphones. Give them back.
What?
Ugh. What's all the ruckus? I can hear you kids all the way over at the lab.
She borrowed my fog lights and never returned them.
Where's my flight simulator?
Fog light, towel.
My headphones. He took my headphones.
What? I wouldn't need them if you didn't have my speakers.
Where's my overhaul? Who's got it? Ow!
Ord? Okay, quiet, please! All of you! Thank you. We'll deal with this in the morning. Until then, I want you all to quit yelling and go to bed.
Oh, man.
Just doesn't seem fair at all.
Good night.
I still want my Orbo Orb. Ow! Thank you.
Attention! Attention, everyone! I've explained the situation to our headmaster, and he's going to hear what you have to say.
Good morning, class. I understand you are all having some trouble sharing. Yes, Robyn?
It's not so much the sharing, really. It's that we have to share. I needed speakers for a group project, but to borrow some from Eagle, I had to loan him my headphones.
And I hardly ever get to play with my own Orbo Orb.
It's like nothing we have is really ours because someone else might need it.
I see. What you are feeling makes sense.
It does?
You cadets do almost everything together. You have very little personal time or space to yourselves. What you need is to have something that is yours, and yours always. So, you are all going to pick one object that no one else can ask you for. Go, now, before class, find one new thing that doesn't belong to someone, and that will be your thing. I think you will find, though, that sharing gains you more than what you hold tight.
We get to pick a thing? Some kind of special tool, maybe.
It's gotta be good. Unique.
An invention, perhaps. Just laying around the lab.
Hi, Hop and Hail Bob. What is it?
Headmaster Crane said we could all pick one thing. A thing that we don't have to share with anyone. Can we have any of your old inventions?
And what a clever headmaster he is. Sure, but only from that pile over there. Everything else, I'm using.
Whoa! Check it out! Night vision glasses! With these, I can see in the dark.
Oh, man! These grippy tires stick to walls. I know what I'm taking.
Wow! Look at this! And I'm not sharing!
And this is mine. Yeah, whatever it is.
This will be so much fun! I can climb up walls into the top of the flight tower. I can eat breakfast on the ceiling if I wanted.
I could drill right through an asteroid instead of flying around.
I can read with the lights off.
All right, cadets, settle down. We got a big day ahead of us. We're taking a field trip to the moon. Actually, into the moon. We're going to collect rock samples from an underground mine up there.
Yes!
Oh, wow! So cool!
Oh, my God! Oh, yes!
Okay, okay. Yeah. No time to waste now. Suit up!
Booster rockets!
Engaged!
Wings!
Back!
Space visors!
Down!
Blast off!
We're gonna be landing in one of the biggest craters anybody's ever seen. It's called the South Pole Aitken Basin. You can't miss it.
It doesn't look like we're at the bottom of a crater.
That's because it's so big, you can't see the sides. Whatever impacted here, it must have been bigger than a city. It's one important thing that you have to remember. No using your jets. This mine is full of elements that react like crazy to heat, and our jets make heat, so absolutely no flying around. Use your wheels. I want you to use the buddy system. Everyone keep an eye on two friends and stay close to each other.
There's all sorts of weird elements down here. No wonder they dug this mine. Hey, what is this metal? I wonder if it's iron oxide or nickel.
Look at the shape of that weird rock. This would make a great addition to my collection.
Hey, you guys.
I bet it came from an asteroid or something. Maybe whatever made this big crater.
You guys!
What?
We lost the group.
Oh, no.
We can catch up.
Wait for me!
Hawk, stop!
Uh-oh, that doesn't sound good. Quick, cadets, let's do a head count. Ava, do you read me?
Eagle, Robyn, Hawk, come in.
We're here!
Yes!
Coach Pigeon will be relieved. Are you all right?
Yeah, we're in a big cave, I think. I can't see very far, but the echo makes it sound really big.
Affirmative. Stay safe. Coach Pigeon is looking for a way to reach you.
Well, he's not going to be coming through that tunnel. It's all full of rubble.
So now what do we do?
We could see if there's another way back. If we could see anything.
Oh, duh. I forgot all about my night vision glasses. Excellent. I can see everything now. Whoa, this place is huge. Be right back.
Hey, I could use my drill to dig our way out.
Look out!
Huh, that won't work.
And it would take days to drill that far anyway.
What are you guys doing?
Yeah! Oh, Robyn, did you find anything?
Nothing. I followed the wall. It's one big circle.
What about up? Did you look up?
I didn't think of that. Ugh, nothing. It's like a big, round dome. But you know what? The top of the cave is so high, I bet it's really close to the surface. Ava?
Yes, Robyn?
How deep are we underground?
43.3 meters.
It's probably just a short way to the surface from up there. If we could only get up there.
I can. My grippy tires, remember? Can't see anything.
Or dig.
Obviously, if one person had the tires
and the glasses
and the drill,
she could dig us out of here.
She?
I'm not gonna just sit down here while you're up there with my tires.
Yeah, you'll break my drill. This is mine, remember? I don't have to share it.
Ugh. What's the point of having these glasses if I don't get to use them here inside a dark cave? Hey! Let's draw straws! And then, the two with short straws shall, by their own free will, share their tools with the winner. Agreed?
Agreed!
Like I said, she.
All right, here you go. Just be sure to go slow and watch out for cracks. They won't grip the stuff that crumbles off.
And give the drill a break every once in a while, so it doesn't get overheated.
Okay, thanks. I couldn't do this without your great tools.
And we couldn't do anything alone either.
Wish me luck. I'm doing what you said, Eagle, and I didn't drive over a crack.
Great.
Here I go. Don't worry. I won't let your drill get too hot, Hawk.
Very considerate.
Okay, you cadets all wait up here while I keep looking. I'm sure there must be a tunnel somewhere. Whoa! Well, there you have it.
Eagle, Hawk, grab on!
Yay!
We're rescued!
Here you go. Why, thank you.
What's going on here? Why'd they stop fighting?
Sharing's not so bad. We got a lot more done together than we ever could have alone. Would you like to sit?
Well, wonders never cease. Isn't this Eagle's spot?
Oh, that's okay. I'm not using it.